persons judged not on the basis of the color of our skin, but on the basis of the content of our character.
One man come in the name of love. One man come and go. One man come, he to justify. One man to overthrow. In the name of love. One more in the name of love. In the name of love. One more in the name of love.
Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was an American clergyman, activist, and prominent leader in the African American civil rights movement. His main legacy was to make progress on civil rights for everybody in the United States of America. He led the 1955 Montgomery bus boycott, which made it okay for black people and white people to sit on the same bus next to each other across Alabama and across the country.
King's efforts led to the 1963 March on Washington, where he delivered his I Have a Dream speech. There, he raised public awareness of the civil rights movement and established himself as one of the greatest public speakers in the U.S. history.
So even though we face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equal.
In 1964, King became the youngest person to receive the Nobel Peace Prize for his work to end racial segregation and racial discrimination through civil disobedience and other nonviolent means.
Was Martin Luther King Jr. a prophet?
Martin Luther King Jr. was a prophet of God. A prophet is somebody who sends God's message. God's message was to love each other, to love your neighbor as yourself. Martin Luther King Jr. propagated this message, and because of that, he is a prophet.
All right, he was not a prophet because he did not communicate with God, and he was just a good man who did good things.
All we say to America is be true to what you said on paper. If I lived in China or even Russia or any totalitarian country, maybe I could understand some of these illegal injunctions. Maybe I could understand the denial of certain basic First Amendment privileges because they haven't committed themselves to that over there. But somewhere I read of the freedom of assembly. Somewhere I read of the freedom of speech. Somewhere I read of the freedom of press. Somewhere I read that the greatness of America is the right to protest far right. And so just as I say we aren't going to let any dogs or water hoses turn us around, we aren't going to let any injunction turn us around. Well, I don't know what will happen now. We've got some difficult days ahead. But it really doesn't matter with me now because I've been to the mountaintop. I don't mind. Like anybody, I would like to live a long life. Longevity has its place. But I'm not concerned about that now. I just want to do God's will. And he's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over. And I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you. But I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land. So I'm happy tonight. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not fearing any man. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord.
MLK has influenced me by giving an example of what one person can do. If you have a dream, follow it. Believe in yourself and it could come true. But it will only happen if you try really hard.
Martin Luther King has influenced me by teaching me not to treat someone by how they look, but by what is in their heart.
Because he created, well, he gave us a sense of equality and freedom in our country, and he spread ideas of peace, and we really benefited from his actions, and we find it necessary to honor them, so we chose this one day to do that.
Throughout our scientific genius, we have made of the world a neighborhood. Now, through our moral and spiritual genius, we must make it of a brotherhood. We are all involved in the single process. Whatever affects one directly affects all indirectly. We are all links in the great chain of humanity.
By the time of his death in 1968, he had refocused his efforts on ending poverty and opposing the Vietnam War from a religious perspective. King was assassinated on April 4th, 1968, in Memphis, Tennessee.
One man caught on a barbed wire fence. One man he resists. One man washed on an empty beach. One man betrayed with a kiss.
Skin color is or what your beliefs are.
We celebrate Martin Luther King Jr. Day in the U.S. because he stopped segregation. But I don't know why we don't celebrate it on his birthday.
We must bolt out the hate and injustice of the old age for the love and justice of the new. This is why I believe so firmly in non-violence. Violence never solves problems. It only creates new and more complicated ones. This love may well be the salvation of our civilization. Dr. Martin Luther King, December 1956.
We shall overcome. Before the victory is won, some of us will have to get scarred up a bit, but we shall overcome.
Late afternoon, April 4th. Shot rings out in the empty sky. Realize they took your life. They could not take your pride. In the name of love. One more in the name of love. In the name of love. One more in the name of love.
Walk, crawl, but by all means, keep moving.